move to GnuTLS. Just done Guile, so we need to do libidn. I don't think we've done this one, have we? Oh, it is there. libidn2 is there. We've not done libidn-1. Let's have a look at the book. libidn, no, we haven't done this one. Okay, it kind of makes sense with what's the dependencies are, the looks of it. Emacs I'm not going to do, gtkdoc. Let's have a look, see what it's about. So that's for API documentation. We've got a JDK, Falkon not installing, and we've just done PTH, so I can install this as it is. Libidn-1. Can configure commands if you are building the API documentation. Need to add that switch, but otherwise, just configuring build as it says there. Time to run the tests. And it looks like that's all passed, so now we'll become the root and install the package. It's all done. There's no configuration, so I'm going to tidy up. And mark that off in chapter 9 and close the tab down. So now on to GnuTLS again. Oh, it did actually say libidn1 or libidn2, didn't see that. So doesn't matter, we've got them both installed. Libsecomp. So this needs which for tests, Valgrind probably for some tests as well. Other than that, there's no other dependencies. So quite a simple install for this one. Some tests. There's one that's passed there as it went up. Okay, so those tests have completed, and it says they're one test passed, so that's all good. So let's now install the package. And tidy up. And this is Chapter 9, General Libraries. Libsecomp is done. So I'll shut that down, and we're back to GnuTLS. NetTools, used during a test suite. And it looks like I might have already brought that up. Can't see it there, so I'm going to bring it up again. Okay, there's no dependencies for this. Oh, I've already installed it, but it looks a bit, that link's gone purple there. Yeah, I have NetTools. Let's just be double sure. Should have ARP, yep, root, yep, okay, it's in, and I'll just make a double check on my list, 15, net tools, yep, okay, that's good. Text live, so again, this is probably for extra documentation. Actually mention this in there. Unbound. Now, I seem to remember having a problem with Unbound previously. It prevented a test from running in another package, and I'm not sure it's because I misconfigured or didn't configure it actually. So I'm not actually going to install that because I had problems previously. There's a caching DNS resolver. Yeah, it says there if you're using DHCP that its resolve gets overridden. So yeah, I'm not going to install this. Like I said, I seem to remember I had to disable it to get things working. It was on, I can't remember what package it was, but I do remember it was running an HTTP test, and that's what led me to think it could be something like this. So apart from that, everything is installed now for GnuTLS, so I shall download it. We've got some extra options here. So P11 kit we've got installed, so we don't need that, but you might do. We could enable this as well. Don't need that because we've got libunistring, so let's copy that much and add in this to build an extra library in case anything wants to use that. Okay, that's finished building. Let's have a look at this status report I've got here. Oh, did I install Valgrind? Don't remember doing that. Maybe I did. Just out of interest. No, I didn't think I did. Don't know why it says yes. Maybe it'll try and use it. Maybe that's what it's saying. So it's going to build some man pages. Okay, yeah, looks all right. So I'm just going to time this. Going to take more than a few minutes for the looks of it, and then the tests I'll time as well because it looks like they'll take even longer. Right, so that has built. I'm going to run the test now. So there you go, that looks like that all passed. So went through, keeping an eye on it, everything went okay, there's no errors. So let's install it. Those last commands for installing documentation for the API documentation, so there's nothing to do there. Unless, of course, you're installing it. And that's GnuTLS done. So that's chapter 4, GnuTLS. Shut that one down. And now we've got one more for glib networking. So I'm going to open this in a new tab. So it requires glib, funnily enough, which we've got, but we're installing kind of circular dependencies, it says there. Maybe for some tests, but it's installed, it will be. So, object introspection is required. Again, this glib. Cairo is required for some tests. Cairo is a package that will get us into a new set of dependencies around, well, as you can see, graphics and so on. So I will install this, but I'm only going to go as far as I need to go. So libpng is going to be the first package. Okay, so is that on SourceForge, is it? Yeah. I need to load both of these links up. Save it. Okay, so it looks like maybe we've already installed this. Yeah, looks like we've already got libpng. So as before, I'm just going to double check my list. So chapter 10. Yeah, like I said, the PNG is crossed off, so that's good. So again, these are packages that have been downloaded on the other browser. And that's why the links haven't changed colour. So Pixman. I'm not going to install GTK yet because, again, I think that will get us involved in a new tree of dependencies. Yep, so I'm going to ignore that for the moment and this will have to be rebuilt, this package. So let's save this link. Okay, looks like we've already done Pixman. So let's check that. Yep, I've got a note as well to build after GTK Plus, so that's good. So Cairo. Not worth checking this one actually. I don't think I've installed it. No, it's not been installed, so what else have we got here? Ghost script. So I'm going to be reinstalling this. Things like ghost script are quite involved. So I'm not going to install much more than what I can get away with. Font config, I think we've done. Let's check that one. Yeah, I think we've done free type as well. So this is chapter 10. Yeah, I've got font config and free type to reinstall, so let's just open that one up so we know it's been looked at. So I'm going to build Cairo as it is and put a mark to rebuild it. And you can see the note there, it does say there's a circular dependency between Cairo and Halfbus, so that's a good a reason in itself to rebuild Cairo. So see Cairo. So I'm not going to install these extra options. I might possibly chance them. They are, just say they're experimental. Which try and avoid really, but see how we go get on. But I'm not going to install them at the moment. And so Cairo is going to be a rebuild. And it's built, there's no tests available, so make install. That's Cairo done. So that's a rebuild after the options have been made. So I'll close that down and tidy up. GJS is the next one. So there's Cairo debus, forgot we're going to reinstall it. Object introspection, which is what we're trying to build. So it looks like I'm going to have to build this, to allow GJS to be built. Build GJS and then rebuild object introspection. So I should do this now. So I'm not going to bother with any extra options here. You see the test related, because I'm not going to run the test at the moment. Just going to get this installed for GJS. Okay, that's built, so I'm just going to do ninja install, and that's done. So I'm going to leave that there. We'll tidy up first. And I've just remembered about the ninja jobs, ninja running with 2+ jobs over the number of cores that you've got, and the potential for that to slow down. So what I'm going to do is to set ninja jobs in the profile, put in the right commands. If I can remember where I'd set the other. I'll see. Yeah, here it is. So what I'm going to do is export nin- ninja jobs equals, I think this was minus J4 as well, let's remember. But better check that. What I can do here is if I go to scratch.org, the best way of doing this is to go to BLFS download and select the single page option. Wait for the page to load because it is rather large. Try and find it if we can, in case it's loaded it. Ninja job. No, it hasn't loaded that part yet. Oh no, it's not BLFS, is it? I've just realised it's in the Linux from scratch part. So let's go back here. Okay, this is getting quite slow now. Let me stop that. No, it's not going to stop. All right, it's just really slow for some reason. It's probably because it's loading the page. So it says minus J20 there, but I want to see explicitly what it should be set to. So let's go back to LFS, read online, download. And stable book. And I want this one here, no chunks. And I'll wait for that to load. It should be quicker, this one. Okay, Control F, Ninja Jobs. And why didn't that work in? Right, there it is. Okay, so it should just be a number. So that's what I wasn't sure about. So just export that like that. And save it. So that's object introspection installed for GJS, and now I need to go to this link here, JS, and this is a JavaScript engine, so that needs Autoconf. Patch. So extract this one. So I presume this is a different version from the one that's in LFS. Yeah, it's an old version. No other explanation for any, or no explanation for any other configuration commands, so I'll just run that as it is. That's done. the tests, make check. Okay, that looks like that's passed 153 tests, so let's go and install the package. And that's that package done, so it's chapter 13, Autoconf. So we've got all these, but I know I'm going to be rebuilding ICU and Rust C, so I'll be reinstalling JS as well. So that's when they're installed. Let's save that. Okay, so we're actually downloading Firefox here, but I presume we're only going to build part of it with this JavaScript library. So, let me tidy up this one. Unlike most other packages in BLFS, instructions below require you to untar this file name and change it to the Firefox folder. Extracting the tarball will reset the permissions of the current directory to 0755 if you have permission to do that. If you do this in a directory where the sticky bit is set, such as temp, it will end with error messages. This does finish with a non-zero status, but it does not mean there is a real problem. Do not untar as root user in a directory where a sticky bit is set. That will unset it. Okay, so we're not the root user. So nothing should change. Let's have a look at the current directory. So it's Kernotex root, and it's 755 is the permissions. Okay, so it's downloaded. So if you're compiling in truth, let's do two things. So we're in the real environment. I think I forgot to mention at the beginning of this BLFS installation is one reason, another reason why I do the way things I do rather than true is because some things can fail, tests and so on can fail. So that's why I try and avoid this, doing this in true. So how long is this likely to build? 2.4, okay, so it's not too bad. Okay, that's extracted. Let's change into it and start building all these commands. So I'm going to time this. And wait for that to finish building. Okay, so it's failed because Rust is not installed, and I thought that was already built, and it obviously isn't. So this requires a few packages. And this may have to be built again after some of these packages have been built, so that's rather unfortunate. So let's go and clear this up. SSH, not sure. No, LibSSH needs to be installed. I think that's one that's in the list to be built. LibSSH. You can see this list is growing again. Yeah, there it is. So I'm going to get rid of that there. So we've got. Interesting. Maybe this is why we're building OpenSSH. I think we've got all of these installed. Oh, GnuPG we need. We've got libgcrypt. So maybe going around in circles again here. GnuPG. Okay, so this has got a lot of dependencies, so libsun. So libgpg error. Yeah, we've done that a little while ago. So I think this can be installed. This must be for documentation again. Yep, different forms of documentation. So let's download this. And we'll just copy and paste this one. It's done. Let's run some tests. All three tests passed. That's good. So it's time to install the package. And we don't need to do that because I haven't installed Text Live. So that was a quick package. So that's chapter 9. Libsun, that's done. So libtreecrit were done, libksba. These libgpg error we've got, falgrind we don't use, so let's save link as. Okay, so nice and easy. Okay, that's done. Let's run some tests. Nice and simple. Make install. And that's done. So that's chapter 9 again. Libksba. Close that down. Next one we've got is nptth. Straightforward. Okay, once again, same as before, simple configure, make check and install. Done, and let's install it. That's it. So general libraries again. nptth. So next one we've got. Pin entry, runtime requirement for most of the packages functionality, so it sounds quite important. So we've got libsun and libgpg. So we've got some graphic-y type stuff here. I'm sure it's what this FLTK is. I guess this is going to have lots of dependencies. Yeah, it's got a few. So I'm going to put this down as a reinstall. We've got the required packages and reinstalled it after the optional ones have been installed. So save link as. So what we've got here, default no. Default is yes, so that's going to be enabled, I guess. So I'm going to run this configure. I'm hoping it will come up with a status at the end so I can see if we do actually need to set anything like this QT option, for example. Or even set this GTK2 to no, because it says the default is yes. So GTK2 is no, so that's good. GNOME 3 is no. Yeah, it looks like it's been clever enough. So to find out what we've got. So that's good. So I'll just run lake. Okay, and install it, and it's done. Okay, so I've marked that down as a reinstall for the options, but for now it's got the basic functionality for GnuPG2. And like I said, I'm not going to bother with these optionals. Image Magic's a graphical package. Could do LibUSB. It's something I would install anyway, even on a basic machine, because obviously it's useful to get access to information about USB ports. So apart from that, I'm going to install this as it is and mark it down to rebuild. PG, so we need to run this setting first, and we can configure enable all tests, enable G13 program. So is that an option, is it? Doesn't say there exactly. Right, I'm not going to enable all the tests. I'll just run the basic tests for now and run them all when I come to reinstall this package. So I'll just install this as it is. Okay, that's built, so I'm going to run the test now with make check. So those tests have passed, or, well, actually says zero tests. Oh yeah, so there has been tests running. For example, at the top there it says three tests run, three succeeded, and at the bottom six tests run, six succeeded. So I'm not quite sure why the overall. It says zero test pass, but there's certainly no errors, so that's okay to install then, I think. sudo su. It does say, note that if you've already installed GnuPG, the instructions below will overwrite this particular file here. And if you created the alternative forms of documentation with TextLive, then you'll need to run that last command as well. So I'll tidy that up. Right, so this does need to be reinstalled for the optional. Okay, so I'll get rid of that for now. And we'll move on to libssh. So really this has got all the optional dependencies built in or installed. So I'm going to start by downloading the package and the patch. Extract it. And just copy and paste these commands in. Okay, that's finished, so I'm going to run the tests, make check. And finally install it. And that's complete. So that's in chapter 9, General Libraries. Probably the biggest chapter in terms of number of packages. Libssh 2. So that's done. And I'll tidy up. Get rid of that one now. Now we can move on to Rust. So this now needs LLVM. It needs CLang from LLVM 12 built with. So Rust can link to the system LLVM for building its own ship version. So let's have a look at that. We've already got a tab for that. LLVM link LLVM dylib on. Yeah, so it has been built with that, so that's good. I think this should be okay to build because it needs CLang. Needs CMake required as well. That should be okay for building. Let's see what CMake had. Yeah, it's just some optional things for testing. Okay, looks like some of these are getting fulfilled now. Might be worth just going through a few of these because Rust depends on a couple of other big packages. So let's. Oh, there's Rust down there. So I've got it twice now. Some of these we've already done, haven't we? I think Libatomic Ops we've done. Yep. And what was the other one? So I'll get rid of that one. Unistring, I think we've done that one. Yep. SU needs LLVM. LLVM. Oh, yeah, it's got quite a few dependencies. So graph is set. Yeah, that's got loads of dependencies, but I think this can be built mostly without a lot of the dependencies. Yeah, a lot of them are optional. So I think that can be done now. Looks like it just augments what GraphFizz can produce there. So that's a possibility. I think Doxygen, that must be for the API docs again. A browsable HTML documentation. That's got quite a few dependencies, yeah. So I think I'll avoid that one. As it doesn't really get used a lot apart from API documentation, which I'm definitely not installing. Although a lot of these, most if not all of these, I will be installing eventually. GraphFizz pigments, let's see what that is. Is that a module? Python module maybe. Yeah, it is. So that's straightforward. Another one there. So it means YAML. Documentation. Oxygen. Right, yeah, I think apart from documentation, we can probably get LLVM installed quite simply. Let's take a look at CMake. So we've got curl is needed to be rebuilt. We've got GCC, so this is Gits and Mercurial. For testing, let's have a look at curl now. Alright, yeah, I think we're fulfilling some of these now. Nice to install Samba because that's useful for accessing Windows machines. That's got lots of dependencies. Lots and lots. Have installed a lot of these though. That one needs to be done, I think. So I wonder if it's worth installing curl a couple more times. Probably about now, because I think all these other dependencies have been installed. S-tunnel, let's have a look at that. Yes, yeah, so that could be installed. So I guess it's just these ones here. Yeah, we are getting through some of these dependencies. There's fewer and fewer with the highlighting on. PCRE2 we've got, I'm sure we've... Yeah, I got that, so let me open that one to highlight that. Link, make it change colour. So that's looking good. Subversion. That's got a few dependencies. I won't bother with the Ruby or the Swig bindings. We've already got Python 2 anyway. So there's just one or two there. So docbook utils, that was required for a couple of these, wasn't it? Doc utils, is it that one there? That's a Python module. Not sure where that's come from now. Right, so where were we going with this? That was glib. Right, let's take a look at a couple of these source control. I normally wouldn't install these because it's for tests, although I do use subversion for some projects, so I would have installed that, but these are primarily for tests for curl, I think it was. No. CMake? Yeah, for CMake. So it'd be good to get good coverage of that, being it's a reasonably big package. So this needs Git. So let's go to Git next. Curl is required to use Git over HTTP, so we don't need the extra functionality that we're rebuilding curl for this purpose. GnuPG, I think we just did, didn't we? Yep. OpenSSH we've got PCRE 2 and PCRE. Subversion this needs, okay. So I think these dependencies are quite easy. SQLite we've got, yeah. Optional Apache 2, what's that got? Is that going to be a load? Yeah, I probably won't install this because it's a server, which is not really what a desktop we use for. So I think I'll concentrate on this little branch next. So let's take a look at Apr-util. First of all, it requires Apr. Okay, so let's do this now. Save link as. APR, so this is just straightforward copy and paste on here, there's no real information about any other options. So as I said there, now we've got configure and a make. Okay, it's built, so let's run the tests. Okay, so that has finished testing, all successfully built, so there's no errors. And let's install. And it's done. So that's APR 1.7.0 marked off. Get rid of that and move on to APR util. So this needs Barclay DB, which I think we've got. Let's just check these. Yep. MariaDB. Right, that's one we haven't got. Open LDAP. So these are requirements. Let's have a look at these two. So again, need CMake, LibEvent, Boost. Let's see what it says down here. What does this do? Right, I don't think the LDAP's important. It's not for testing. It's probably for the tool to use that functionality. Arguably MariaDB, I will be installing that, but given the dependencies it's got, I think I want to leave that for the moment. PostgreSQL. Won't be installing that because I don't need it. So an SQLite we've already got. So I think I'm tempted to install this as it is. Let's see what it finds when we configure it. So let's just check this. So we can add that in because we've got Barclay DB already installed and we don't add that one in, so let's copy the configure, add in this switch and configure it for that. Right, so it's configured. I was hoping it would put a report out to say what it's using and so on, but it hasn't, unfortunately. So I'm just going to build it. That's all done. We've got some tests to run, but they must be run on one thread. Right, yep, we did get one failure, test DBM as it says in the book, so that's fine. Let's just install it. What am I typing? And that's complete, so there's no configuration. So Apr-util, directly under the previous package APR in chapter 9. Get rid of that. So let's see what else we need for subversion now. Got SQLite, Surf we need. So this has got a couple of dependencies, Scons. Not installing MitKerberos, so we can go straight to this. We've got these two now. So let's just save this. Okay, is it on source forge? Yeah, it is. Okay, we'll shut that down. Go back to Scons and extract it. Notice that the output directory is capital SC. So there's no configuration information. It says to run it as root, so let's become root and just copy all of these commands in to build it. So that's built. Tidy up. And mark that off under chapter 13, programming. And move on to Surf.